I'm Scott Martin. We're at NCATS. That's the National Center for Advancing Translational Sciences. And I'm with the Division of Preclinical Innovation. Our role is to find out what human genes do in the context of different biological processes. As a kid, I grew up in New York City. I was a late bloomer in school. I spent most of my time playing baseball on the streets and just having fun. And I developed sort of a knack for math and science. I selected a lab that made small molecules and applied them to cancer cells and other biological systems to see what would happen. And the greatest thing about science is that it always changes. What I do today won't be what I'm doing 10 years from now. So what we do is we use this technology termed RNAi screening, and that allows us to downregulate, to turn down each gene in the human genome. There's about 20,000 genes in the human genome, and ask how that affects a process. We can ask what genes are important for the spread of cancer. We can ask what human genes are important for the spread of different viruses, such as Ebola or pox virus. We have in our portfolio right now about 40 different projects that span really a wide variety of exciting biology. Today we'll be working on your melanoma project. We'll be able to look for any genes that are important for your melanoma cells that could be used in the clinic in the future. For us to interrogate the entire human genome, over 20,000 human genes, we have to do many, many experiments. What we have over here is a robotic platform where we can transfer materials using 384 plastic tips to transfer materials into this plate. It's called the microplate. We could do 384 different experiments. And then we could take those plates and incubate them at body temperature in any one given experiment of 20,000 genes. I guess you would say your overall success rate, it's fairly high. Know that this gene is important in the spread of Ebola virus, or this gene is important in the migration of cancer cells. Nadia is prepping cells right now for this experiment, and they're now ready to be used, and they'll be fed to this dispense head where we'll be able to add cells and other reagents to enable those sRNAs to go into the cells and downregulate the genes. We'll ask if any of the genes we downregulated have affected the growth and spread of the virus in the wells that we've added virus to. So the cells she's preparing, we grow in these incubators for harvesting for the experiment. We look for spread of virus by taking pictures of every single well in the experiment and quantitate how much virus is spread. Once we acquire all of that data, we communicate with our collaborators. As we accumulate all of this information across many different systems, we begin to understand how all genes work and how they tie together. And right now we're in a paradigm where most drugs that people take are small molecules. The next step is developing tools to then affect what's wrong in the diseased cells, for example. I think it's very easy in really all areas of life, not just your career, to get yourself onto a path that's not gonna lead to fulfillment of your life. And I think that it's important that people be honest with themselves in terms of what they're passionate about and what they're pursuing and change things, because that's definitely possible throughout your life. Thank you.